I'm not sure what happened to me on that day, but once I entered into the Boylston Street, I can hear one explosion, boom, boom. I thought it's a fireworks, you know, then saw smoke, it's on my left side. And I just carry on, and everybody was thinking of that, you know. When the second bomb exploded, it's about 2 seconds only, you know, that's where everybody was screaming, you know. They said, hey, it's explosion, explosion, bomb. And that's where police came in. Immediately they come and they block us, so we could not enter to the pen. It's between 700 meters, they really block the area. Then all the runners are coming forward to me, and I'm confusing, because why I'm confusing? First of all, my mindset, I got friends down there. I don't know what really happened. I don't know. My mind is not thinking about bomb, you know. My mind was thinking is, oh, it could be something happened. We don't know what is that. So I was standing on the other side. I took some pictures of the area. I managed to have some pictures. Then after that, I just move around. It takes me nearly 1.5 kilometers to walk. To walk to the other location, need to go the other location and collect my backpack down there. Everybody help, they ask me, you want any phone? I say, I'm confusing, I want to contact my friend. I need Wi-Fi, there's no Wi-Fi. And finally, when I got my bag, that's terrible, but I have to walk from that corner, no train. Everywhere has been blocked. And from the corner, my baggage to my hotel at Holiday Inn takes me, the hotel is about 5 kilometers. With the leg pain, shivering, just walk all the station up the road. So when I reach at my hotel, immediately I go down to go YouTube there and check, go to Facebook, PM my friend from US. Her name is Salina. She's migrate there. Straight away send her message, Salina, where are you? Are you at that location? And she replied me, she's safe from that location. She was about 500 meters. Yeah, it's not 500 meters. I think it's less than 500 meters. Because she was at the other grandstand. And just, the thing he said, just an explosion. So we went back, waited for her at the hotel. She came back to me, we hugged, cried, you know. We were happy that everyone is safe, but we are not sure any Singaporean or any other supporters at that location. That is the time when I saw the news that it's very sad. It's like Singapore flag, it's just in front of our Singapore flag.